Water experts are predicting a comeback of red tide blooms, and they're blaming it on Saharan dust that's headed our way.
This dust has a lot of iron, a nutrient that feeds red tide blooms. NBC2's Devin Turk is live on Fort Myers Beach with what experts are watching out for.
Well, the water looks beautiful out here on Fort Myers Beach. It's nothing like what we saw a couple years ago when the coastlines here were plagued with dead fish and marine life. But scientists warn that the Saharan dust could cause issues with red tide.
It's making it hard to see and breathe in the Caribbean.
It looks almost completely gray, just sort of this odd cast to the sky.
And that Saharan dust is on its way to Florida.
Scientists who study these plumes are saying this is one of the most significant plumes we've had in a number of decades.
Saharan dust is full of iron. Many organisms, including Trichodesrium, a cyanobacteria in the Gulf, need that iron.
It's a marine cyanobacteria that can take nitrogen gas out of the air and basically turn it into fertilizer, nitrogen fertilizer. But it needs a lot of iron to do that.
But fertilizer can support red tide blooms.
When the Saharan dust brings the iron into the Gulf of Mexico, it basically fertilizes the water, allowing the Trichodesmium to bloom. When Trichodesmium blooms, it makes a lot of nitrogen fertilizer, and we think that can then feed a red tide.
FGCU's Dr. Mike Parsons says our red tide blooms typically start in late September, so he's not overly concerned about a bloom now.
Just because you have a Trichodesmium bloom doesn't mean you're going to get a red tide. It has to be synchronized in the right way. And so if you got one of these blooms later in the summertime, maybe it would be better synchronized for when we would see a red tide.
And Parsons says they'll continue to do water samples and tests, especially as this Saharan dust comes through here, just keeping an eye on things. Reporting live in Fort Myers Beach, Devin Turk, NBC2.